Today, what I'm going to talk about is cruise travel hacks, and really the cruise travel hacks that repeat cruisers use to save money and to really have the very best cruise experience. So let's get started on the 12 tips right now. I'm Ilana from the website and blog Life Well Cruised, where we help thousands of cruisers a month get ready for their cruise with our cruise travel tips. Now, before I get started, I just wanted to mention that if you do like this video, please do give it a thumbs up. It really does help me and I really do appreciate it. As well, leave me a comment and let me know about your cruise travel hacks. What's helped you to save money, to have the very best cruise, and what are like tips that other cruisers could use? So please leave that in the comments below. And of course, share and subscribe if you do like cruise content like this. Number one. So I'm gonna get started with one that you really wouldn't even think about right at the very beginning when you're planning your cruise. But I think it's just such a good one that I wanted to mention it right away. And it's to book your next cruise on board. Now, the fact is that the cruise line will actually give you an incentive when you do this. They'll actually give you a couple incentives. So one is they're gonna give you some extra money to spend either on this cruise that you're on now or on your next cruise, which is amazing, in the form of onboard credits. The second thing they're gonna do is they're gonna offer you an opportunity to put down a reduced deposit. So it's really win-win. Now, just a little tip, if you're in a mindset that you're like, I don't know what my next cruise is gonna be, I can't plan for the next one on this one, personally, I'm like that. So what I do is I ask if I can make an open booking. Now, in some cases, this works and I can make a completely open booking. Sometimes cruise lines do have that option. Other times I have to choose a date and the future cruise consultant is wonderful at helping me to do that. We choose a date far in the future, maybe a year and a half or so far away. And then what I can do, as long as the terms and conditions say that I can do that, so I watch that, is that I could bring that cruise forward. So I might book something for a year and a half or so down the line. And then when I get home and I work on it and I look to see what I really want to do, then I bring that cruise forward. Now do check the terms and conditions. Make sure that if you are not 100% sure that that future cruise deposit is a refundable one, there are a couple of different kinds. So do make sure of that, but that is a great tip and you can get up to $200, $300 and more of future onboard credit on your next cruise. Number two, book your own shore excursion. So rather than booking the shore excursions with the cruise line that can really, really add up, do a little bit of research to see what ports you can actually go on your own, either by booking an excursion locally, online ahead of time, maybe with really, really good recommendations, or even some cruise ports you can easily just take a cab to a beach. Now do make sure that whatever you're doing, you are doing research to make sure that you are making it back to the ship on time. That's very important. I'm gonna link a video just above about making sure that you are not a pier runner, you're not somebody who doesn't get back to the ship on time. That is very, very important, so I'm not encouraging that. But there are ways to actually do your own excursions in cruise ports safely and cautiously. And I will give you another little tip. Check with the cruise line that you are booked with to see if they have a price matching policy on shore excursions. There are some cruise lines, Princess is one of them, that if you find a shore excursion that is less expensive, there are some conditions, you do need to find it online. It does need to be quite similar, but there is actually a price matching policy so that you can actually still book it with the cruise line and still get that lower price. So that's a little tip for you. I'm gonna leave a blog post below all about Princess and some different little tips and tricks so that you can have that information if you are cruising with Princess. And like I mentioned, up above, you will find also the link to the video to make sure you do not miss the cruise trip, because we don't wanna do that. Number three. If you are not super picky about cruise cabins, but you do wanna make sure that you kinda get the best cabin that you can for the money, is that you can actually bid for cabin upgrades. So what I mean by this is, if you don't really mind having an inside cabin, an ocean view, or even a balcony, choose the cabin that is the lowest cabin category that you will still be happy with for your cruise. And then as it gets a little bit closer, cruise lines will often offer you the opportunity to bid for an upgrade. And that can mean that you're bidding $50, $100, $200 more per person or more to have the opportunity to bid for a better cabin. And I can tell you that we were on a recent cruise and we met a family and they were booked in an ocean view cabin for four. They bid a total of $200 per person. If I'm not mistaken, it may have been $400 per person because they only asked for the first two, but they bid this amount and they actually got a family veranda, which they were very, very, very happy with. So it is something that you can do, book the cabin. That is still something you'll be happy with. And remember that if a cruise is sold out, you may not be able to have that opportunity to get an upgrade. So it's not 100%, but it is something that you can do and you can get a cabin upgrade for a lot less. Number four. Now, when we first started cruising, there were no beverage packages. Now that was a while ago, more than 15 years ago, but now cruise lines have beverage packages and sometimes these can be amazing deals. Now, oftentimes, if you can actually choose this as a perk, that will be your best way to get the best value from a beverage package. But otherwise, still look into a beverage package to see if it might have value for you, because beverages, of course, as we know, are very expensive on cruises. And do of course look at what beverages are included just to make sure that it is the right package for you. Number five, are you on social media? If you are, I cannot think of a better place to get all of the information than on Facebook. And what I mean by this is on Facebook, there are these very active groups for Royal Caribbean, for Princess, for Celebrity, for Carnival, and more. So join the specific group on Facebook for your cruise line, and sometimes you can even find it for your ship. And the reason to do this is because as soon as there's any news, like beverage packages that go on sale, that will spread like wildfire in these groups. And I can tell you that several months ago, it may have been about a year ago, there was a little bit of a glitch, a pricing mistake by Royal Caribbean, where they were offering a beverage package with alcohol for $18 a person. So obviously this was This was obviously a total glitch and it shouldn't have happened and it was a mistake. But that news spread like wildfire and many people were able to take advantage of that mistake. Now, usually that's not going to happen, but even a sale where something goes on sale for 20, 30, 50% off, you will be able to find that out quickly. So join those Facebook groups to find that out. And as well, you may want to join the Lifewell Cruise Facebook group for information, but these specific cruise line groups are the best for those tips and deals specifically for those ships and cruises. Number six. A great time to find sales on the things that you might want to do are on embarkation day and as well online before your cruise. So what I mean by this is services like spa services and even specialty dining on the first day are often on sale on embarkation day. So do take a look at that as soon as you get on the ship. As well, before you get on the cruise, do take a look through your cruise personalizer, all of the information online. Watch those emails for those extra promotions that are available before you get on your ship for Wi-Fi, for beverage packages, for shore excursions, and more. Number seven, do you like to shop on board, perhaps at the duty-free shop? I personally really do. I don't buy an absolute ton, but I do look, and many cruisers do like to do a lot of shopping on their cruise ship. So there are some good deals to be had on cruise ships when you want to shop in the duty-free stores. So one thing to look for is actually to go into some of the jewelry shops, as well as even the souvenir shops, different things, and to take a look at some of their closeouts and their liquidations. And I can tell you that my son picked up a phenomenal deal. It was like one of those get the car moments. It was just amazing. On a Princess ship that we were on about a year ago, and he picked up a Gucci watch for a terrific price. If you want to know the details, I'm going to leave you the blog post below that I describe the deals that can be had on duty-free shopping, but definitely there are some deals to be had as well. Take a look while you're on the ship for when things are 10% or even 50% off. They will have different sales from day to day, and you can ask even on the cruise, you can even ask the shopkeepers when some of that's going to happen, and take a look and keep an eye on your daily schedules, your cruise compass, your, you know, princess patter, all of those different things. Take a look and keep an eye on that for really getting the best deals on the cruise ship. Number eight, something that a lot of avid cruisers do is they buy cruise line shares. Now, there are, this is a financial investment. So of course, do check for yourself if this is the right investment for you, if this makes sense. But in terms of getting extra perks, extra benefits, you do get this when you buy a certain amount of shares with the cruise line. So for instance, Carnival Corporation or Royal Caribbean or Norwegian. So do take a look at this and see if it's value for you, but the additional onboard credit can be $100 all the way up to $300 and even more depending on the length of sailing. And you can see if this is a good deal for you, but a lot of avid cruisers definitely swear by it. Parents. Kids sail free dates. So definitely, if you are a parent sailing with kids, now of course they have to sail in the same cabin as you, but this is a phenomenal deal. And there are some family-friendly lines that often have these kids sail free or kids sail at reduced rates. And definitely take a look at this. And sometimes, oftentimes they're not available on the holiday sailings, but I have seen them actually even on March break dates. So definitely don't discount this. If you are a parent, take a look at the family-friendly cruise lines to see what kind of deals you can have where your kids might sail for much, much less. Number 10. Now this might be surprising, but consider booking with a travel agent. Now a lot of people, especially if it's their first cruise, don't realize that most of the time travel agents don't charge a fee. So when a travel agent doesn't charge a fee, what this just means is that the price that you will get by working with a travel agent is the same as the cruise line or better. And oftentimes it could be better, but you will also get, if the price is the same, oftentimes you will get extra perks from a travel agent. Now this could mean a local travel agent, but it also could mean a travel agent online or a larger travel agent contingency. But definitely take a look and compare to see what is the best value and the best deal for you. But definitely many avid cruisers swear by using a travel agent to be able to get their best deal and their best perks on their next cruise. Number 11, book early and then monitor your pricing. So what I mean by this is book as early as you possibly can. That might be 6 months in advance, that might be a year in advance, that might be a year and a half in advance. But oftentimes, cruise lines will allow you to refare and to even take advantage of new promotions as it gets closer. So by doing this, you can almost always ensure that you are actually getting the best price. And I've done some comparisons, and oftentimes the pricing that is available a year or more in advance is significantly better than the price as we get closer to the cruise. Definitely compare what is the best for you, but consider booking early and monitoring that price. Number 12. So we are at the end. So the last tip is actually about right before your cruise. So it's in terms of hotel stays. Now, sometimes some people, especially if it's their first cruise, will try to fly in on the same day, and that could be a way to save money, but I caution you, don't do that. Instead of flying in the same day as your cruise, book to arrive and do your hotel stay 1 day before the cruise. And the reason for this is actually to have peace of mind, to make sure that you don't miss the ship, all of those different things, but you can still save money on that hotel stay. So do take a look at your credit card, do take a look at the points that you might be getting, and consider using the points that you can get by maybe with the travel agency that you were using or the points that you're getting on your credit card, and use those points to kind of travel hack your way to getting a great deal on your hotel stay the night before your cruise. But you will not regret flying in the day before and having a nice relaxing evening before your cruise and starting the morning off right, getting to your cruise nice and early and having the very best start to your cruise vacation. So I hope that these 12 cruise travel hacks have been helpful for you as you plan your next cruise. And I thank you for sticking with me for all 12 of them. Now, I'd love to connect with you further. I am on Instagram and I am on Facebook under Life While Cruise, and I'd love to connect with you there. As well, of course, if you did like this video, it would mean the world to me if you gave it a thumbs up. It actually really does help YouTube to show this video more, and I definitely do appreciate it. And of course, please consider subscribing to the channel if you like this content and other content like this. There are also some cruise vlogs that we do as well. Thank you so much and happy cruising.